Hey everyone, welcome back to the current affairs series on agriculture and rural development for the NABARD exam. My name is Pooja Rawat and this is our 22nd session in the series. So all those people who are here for the first time, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and press this bell icon so that you don't miss on the latest updates. You can also join our Telegram group wherein you can discuss among the peers, you can post your queries and you'll be updated with the upcoming videos. Let's start our session. This is the first question. It says, the scheme Biotech Krishi Innovation Science Application Network is under the aegis of which ministry? Right? Here the correct answer is Ministry of Science Technology. So as the name suggests, Biotech Krishi Innovation Science Application Network. Okay, so there would be a network of institutions, right? And नाम से सजेस्ट कर रहा है साइंस का एप्लीकेशन होगा, इनोवेशन साइंस का एप्लीकेशन, यानी कि वट एवर टेक्नोलॉजीज यू हैव एट द लेबोरेटरी लेवल दे विल बी इम्प्लीमेंटेड एट द फार्म लेवल, राइट? बट हियर अ कैच. फर्स्ट थिंग रिमेंबर दैट दिस स्कीम वॉज लॉन्च बाय मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ साइंस टेक्नोलॉजी इन 2017. ओके, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ बायोटेक्नोलॉजी इज द नोडल डिपार्टमेंट फॉर द इम्प्लीमेंटेशन ऑफ स्कीम. ऑब्जेक्टिव क्या है इसका? ठीक है कि साइंस इनोवेशन साइंस का एप्लीकेशन तो होगा लोकल लेवल पर, बट कैसे होगा? हाउ? हेयर देयर विल बी अ पार्टनरशिप बिटवीन द साइंटिस्ट्स एंड फार्मर्स. ओके, सो साइंटिस्ट फर्स्ट ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड द प्रॉब्लम्स ऑफ फार्मर्स, बी इट रिलेटेड टू सॉइल, सीड or market. Okay, they'll try to understand these problems and then provide the necessary solution or the technology. Okay, the solution or technology to solve these farmers' problem. All right, so this was the broader objective of the scheme. Now let's try to study this in detail. So this is a scientist farmer partnership scheme launched in 2017 by Ministry of साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी. तो साइंटिस्ट फार्मर की पार्टनरशिप कैसे होगी हमने एक्सप्लेन कर लिया. फार्मर्स विल टेल देयर प्रॉब्लम्स, दे विल पार्टिसिपेट इन दिस स्कीम. सो दे विल इन्फॉर्म दी साइंटिस्ट व्हाट आर देयर प्रॉब्लम्स दे आर फेसिंग एट द लोकल लेवल, एट द फील्ड लेवल, राइट? एंड देन दी साइंटिस्ट विल प्रोवाइड द इनोवेटिव सोल्यूशन एंड टेक्नोलॉजीज टू सॉल्व दीज प्रॉब्लम्स. सो ऑब्जेक्टिव इज टू कनेक्ट दी साइंस लेबॉरिटीज विद द फार्मर्स टू find these innovative solution and the technologies. So we've discussed that. Now it is a pan India program. So this scheme is being implemented at the India level, right? So entire country has been divided into 15 agroclimatic zones by the planning commission, right? So at each agroclimatic zones we have different biotech kisan hubs. Okay, so we have different hubs here and they are implementing these schemes. So they are following a hub and spoke model. This scheme or this program is following this hub and spoke model. अब इसमें hub and spoke model होता है क्या? Let's understand this. So there will be a central agency here, and then there would be secondary branches all over the country. Okay. So एक हब एंड स्पोक मॉडल का फ़ायदा ये होता है कि देर इज़ अ सेंट्रल अथॉरिटी, सेंट्रल एजेंसी जो कि सारी सेकेंडरी ब्रांचेस को मॉनिटर कर पाएगी, सो दैट दिस स्कीम का जो इम्प्लीमेंटेशन है वो सीमलेस हो पाए, है ना? देर विल बी अ कॉन्टीन्यूस मॉनिटरिंग एंड अथॉरिटी ओवर दीज सेकेंडरी ब्रांचेस, राइट? सो दिस स्कीम इज़ फॉलोइंग दिस मॉडल एंड इट स्टिमुलेट्स एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप एंड इनोवेशन इन द फार्मर्स एंड एम्पावर्स वुमेन फार्मर्स. सो दिस स्कीम ऑल्सो identifies the leadership skills or the leadership role of the farmers irrespective of their gender, be it male or female, right? And it also encourages women farmers to take these entrepreneurship initiatives so that their income could be enhanced and so that their standard of living could be increased. Now another point here is these biotech kisan hubs are expected to fulfill the technology required to generate agriculture and biosource related jobs and better livelihood. So this will also take care of the jobs related to agriculture or bio resource, that is genetically engineered crops हैं या micro organism जो introduce किए जाते हैं, modify किए जाते हैं, उससे related जितने भी jobs होंगे that would also be taken care under this program. और biotech किसान hubs would be responsible for that, alright? So farmers are also exposed to best global farm management and practices. So under this schemes, farmers are also introduced or acquainted with the existing farm practices, with the best practices at the global level. So global level पे या different countries किस तरीके के farm practices को adopt कर रही हैं, ठीक है, और किस तरीके से these practices are helping in increasing their yield and income. So our farmers would also be introduced with those technologies and practices, right? So this was all about the Biotech Kisan program. Now moving forward to the next question we have. Yellow Gold 48 is a variety of what? A mango, mustard, watermelon or wheat? So this is a variety of watermelon. Okay, so this variety is recently being introduced in India. Or commercially introduced in India by Bayer's. This is a German company, okay, Bayer. So already there were field trials going on for around 2 years, right? And now this variety is commercially introduced in the India. Ab fayda kya hai yellow gold 48 ka? First thing, it has high yield. Theek hai? High yield, aur isi wajah se it has high income potential. High income potential. अब high income potential कैसे for these watermelon growers? Because there's a growing demand for exotic fruits in India or in other countries also, right? So there are chances of exporting this variety to different countries or urban spaces में there is a growing demand for the exotic fruits. So farmers will get better prices for these varieties. Okay, so it will introduce the different options available for these watermelon growers so that they can diversify their produce and they can get more income for the same produce. Alright, so this was about the yellow gold 48, remember this. Now question number 3, it says rubber board has started field trial of world's first GM, that is a genetically modified rubber in the state of. Okay, so recently rubber board has started the field trial of this GM rubber and this is first time in the world that GM rubber has been introduced in anywhere, right? So this has been introduced in the Assam state. So this rubber board is a statutory body. Okay. It was established in 1947 by the government of India under the rubber board act of 1947. Okay, so they've started this field trial. Although ye jo field trial tha pehle Kerala mein hone wala tha and GAAC has already approved its field trial in 2010, but Kerala government has its reservation against its introduction because of the adverse impact on the environment, or I would say because of the potential adverse impacts, because we are not sure if how they are going to impact the environment. Okay, so Kerala government has opposed its introduction there. So now this rubber board or the GM rubber has been introduced in the state of Assam here. Now let's understand more about the GM rubber. So this is the second genetically modified crop for which field trial has started after the BT cotton. ठीक है, तो बीटी कॉटन के ऑलरेडी फील्ड ट्रायल हो चुका है और यू नो दैट बीटी कॉटन हैज़ बीन ग्रोन बाय मेनी फार्मर्स नाउ. नाउ जीएएसी हैज़ अलाउड दिस ओपन फील्ड ट्रायल्स ऑफ जीएम रबर इन 2018. सो जीएएसी इज़ द एपेक्स बॉडी दैट इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर दीज जीएम क्रॉप्स, राइट? तो जेनेटिकली इंजीनियर्ड जितनी भी क्रॉप्स हैं और genetically modified organisms जो होती है उनका introduction, storage और their export, import, everything is controlled by this committee GAAC and this functions under the Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change. So remember this point. Now what is the significance of GM rubber? GM variant rubber has the capacity to withstand adverse climatic कंडीशन. तो जीएम जितनी भी जेनेटिकली मॉडिफाइड क्रॉप्स होती हैं उनका फ़ायदा यही होता है, दे हैव दिस इनहेरेंट कैपेसिटी. हम मतलब जो भी डिजायर्ड क्वालिटीज़ होंगी वी कैन इंट्रोड्यूस्ड बाय मॉडिफाइंग देयर जीन्स, राइट. सो इट हैज़ द कैपेसिटी टू फाइट दिस क्लाइमेटिक कंडीशन. इट इज़ रेजिस्टेंट टू ड्रॉट और रिड्यूस सॉइल मॉइस्चर, राइट. सो अंडर ड्रॉट कंडीशन ऑल्सो दिस क्रॉप कैन बी ग्रोन. And then this is also reduces to temperature extremes, be it low or high temperature, as well as the high light intensity, right? Then it will also cut short the maturity period of rubber, right? So GM rubber जो होगी this will take less time to mature. Less time अगर कोई भी crop लेती है that means it is basically saving the farmers time and input, है ना. For example अगर कोई क्रॉप 6 मंथ लेती है ग्रो करने में तो फार्मर्स को 6 मंथ तक इनपुट भी प्रोवाइड करना पड़ेगा इन द फॉर्म ऑफ वाटर. इरिगेशन प्रोवाइड करना पड़ रहा है 6 महीने तक, फर्टिलाइजर प्रोवाइड करना पड़ रहा है, टाइम देना पड़ रहा है, राइट. ही कैन नॉट ग्रो अदर क्रॉप एट दैट पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम. बट अगर मेच्योरिटी पीरियड अगर कम हो जाता है, फॉर एग्जाम्पल एनी क्रॉप इज टेकिंग ओनली 3 मंथ्स इन द प्लेस ऑफ 6 मंथ, राइट. सो इट्स डेफिनेटली गोइंग टू सेव अ लॉट ऑफ input a lot of money and time of the farmer, right. So it will give the additional income to the farmers. So this is the benefit of this short maturity period. Then it will give a boost to rubber production in India and will greatly benefit farmers since it is resistant to the extreme temperature or the drought condition or the high light intensity, right. So this crop can be grown under varied agroclimatic conditions, right. So it's going to boost the rubber production in India and will definitely going to benefit farmers to provide the additional income to the farmers, right. Now moving forward to the fourth question, it says Agriculture Diversification Scheme 2021 is recently being e-launched by the Gujarat government. Now with respect to it, choose the correct statement. So this scheme is being virtually launched by the Gujarat government recently. Now there are different statements with respect to it. First is, it primarily aims to assist the farmers in the tribal areas. Absolutely correct. So this scheme is launched for the Vanbandhu farmers. Okay. These are tribal people, right? So first one is correct. Second, under this scheme, 45 kg of urea, 50 kg of NPK and 50 kg of ammonium sulfate will be provided to these farmers. This one is also correct. So this is the fertilizer. These are the fertilizers. So under this scheme, fertilizer assistance is given to the farmers. Third, seeds of crops such as maize, millet, tomato, bitter melon, etc. will also be provided. This one is also correct. So this scheme is basically a seed fertilizer assistance scheme. ठीक है, steam for seed fertilizer assistance scheme है ये. तो इस scheme के under जो government होगी, they will provide these seeds or these fertilizers to the farmers so that the product could be increased, the yield could be increased, right? And this will provide the income to the farmers. So क्या होगा, उनका standard of living बढ़ेगा. So गुजरात में इस एरियाज में क्या होता है, इरीगेशन प्रॉपर फैसिलिटीज नहीं है इन ट्राइबल पीपल्स के लिए, राइट. दे डू नॉट हैव द लेटेस्ट टेक्नोलॉजीज अवेलेबल. दिस फार्मर्स आर मेनली, जो ट्राइबल पीपल्स हैं, दे आर मेनली स्मॉल एंड मार्जिनल फार्मर्स. दे कैन नॉट इम्प्लीमेंट टेक्नोलॉजीज एट देयर फार्म लेवल, राइट. एंड ऑल्सो दे आर नॉट अवेयर और दे नॉट हैव एडिक्वेट इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट द लेटेस्ट टेक्नोलॉजीज और लेटेस्ट फार्म इम्प्लीमेंट्स और द लेटेस्ट सीड्स विच आर अवेलेबल outside these areas, right. So the government has launched this scheme so that they will give this assistance in the form of free seeds and fertilizer so that the yield of these crops could be increased, right, and it will provide the income to these farmers and their standard of living would be improved. So this was all about the Agriculture Diversification Scheme 2021. All of these statements are correct and the correct option here would be D, that is all of the above. Now, the last question of today's session is, what is the percentage share of agriculture and elite sectors to the national GDP in 2021? Okay, very important. 2021 GDP mein agriculture and elite sector ka kitna contribution tha? Option hai 17.7, 18.5, 19.9 and 15.6. The correct option here is 19.9. So this is very important because although there was a situation of pandemic, COVID-19 was going on, but agriculture production ka share dekhen GDP mein, so it has been increased to nearly 20%, 19.9%, that means it's nearly 20%. ठीक है, और आपको पता है काफ़ी टाइम से जो एग्रीकल्चर का कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन था इट वॉज अराउंड 17.5%, या इट वॉज स्टैगनेंट अराउंड 17%. सो दिस इज़ द बिगेस्ट आई वुड से एन अचीवमेंट फॉर द एग्रीकल्चर सेक्टर दैट despite of this pandemic situation, the contribution of the agriculture and elite sectors to the national GDP has increased and it has been now in 19.9%. So remember this figure. Okay, so this was all about today's session. I hope you like it. In case you have any queries, you can post it down, and yeah, we'll see you in the next session. Till then, keep working hard, keep studying.